Hello, I'm Deborah Quilter, and I'm here to tell you a little bit about repetitive strain injury, or RSI. It's also known as a cumulative trauma disorder. There are many different ways that the medical community will refer to this, but for our purposes, we're going to call it RSI. What exactly is repetitive strain injury? It's an umbrella term for many different ailments that happen to the upper extremity. And these are cumulative trauma disorders that are caused by overuse of the hand and arm. And the injury can happen to the fingers, the thumb, the wrists, the forearms, the upper arms, the shoulders, the neck. RSI includes many ailments: de Quervain's disease, tendinitis, tenosynovitis, epicondylitis. You might hear of golfer's elbow, tennis elbow, bowler's elbow. Those are epicondylitis. And carpal tunnel syndrome, to name a few. Repetitive strain injury is not the same thing as carpal tunnel syndrome. Carpal tunnel syndrome is one form of RSI, but the terms are not synonymous. In fact, carpal tunnel syndrome is not necessarily the most common form of RSI. And many people have more than one of these diagnoses, so it can be a complicated medical problem. And while people who have RSI can share many common complaints, no two cases are exactly alike. RSI varies according to individual physical weaknesses, faulty work habits, or poor workstation setups. Some people get pain in their shoulders and necks. Other people feel pain in their wrists and hands. And there are people who don't have much pain at all, but instead experience extreme weakness or clumsiness. So that's a little bit about what RSI is. In our next segment, we're going to talk about the risk factors for RSI. And then in a following segment, we're going to talk about the warning signs.